So betting on yourself sounds good, really like a no-brainer. Of course you should bet on yourself. If you don't, who will? But in truth, it's never that simple, because even once you do place that bet, so many things that aren't going to be up to you will determine whether it pays off. Take Raptors president Masai Ujiri, who last year, after getting swept out of the playoffs again by LeBron James, specifically told reporters, quote, "It's on me. Put it on me." And that sounds good, accountability and all that. But then what? Think about all the things Masai had to do after that nice little speech and all the things that could have gone wrong. First, he fired coach Dwane Casey, one of the nicer humans in the sport, who had just guided the Raptors to their most successful regular season ever. Masai did this knowing full well that Casey was up for coach of the year. And in fact, just a few weeks later, Casey won it, which didn't look great. Then, as it became clear that the Spurs were going to trade Kawhi Leonard, Masai took another enormous gamble, offering up his team's most beloved player, a four-time All-Star. And again, you can frame this as Ujiri betting on himself and his ability to assess talent, but let's not kid ourselves. Masai didn't know what he was bringing back in Kawhi. He didn't know the state of Kawhi's health or if Kawhi would ever return to the form that had made him one of the top five players in the game. He didn't know if Kawhi would be willing to buy in or trust what the Raptors wanted to do this season, because Kawhi had just spent the previous season clearly no longer trusting the folks in San Antonio. Really, the only thing Masai knew for sure is that Kawhi's contract would be up in less than a year and that there was a better than even chance that Kawhi would move on after that. Oh, and then there was the matter of Toronto's other All-Star, Kyle Lowry, who was so upset about the way the trade was handled, he went months without even speaking to Ujiri. In fact, it took until February for the two of them to sit down and clear the air with each other, which was also right around the time Masai threw his chips into the middle of the table again, deciding to sacrifice a bunch of the depth that he'd spent years building to acquire Marc Gasol. And hey, now all of it looks very smart. Kawhi Leonard, clearly as elite as ever. Lowry, bought back in. Nick Nurse has made the in-series adjustments that, frankly, had been missing from previous playoff runs. And Masai certainly had been hoping and planning for all that to happen, but it took other people to actually do their part of all that stuff. And it also took some luck. If Joel Embiid hadn't caught a stomach flu, does Toronto still squeak by Philadelphia? If when Kawhi launched that buzzer beater, if it had bounced, I don't know, five times instead of four, would it still have fallen in the hoop? You know how Fred VanVleet spent most of the playoffs in the grip of a terrible slump, but the birth of his son is what gave him perspective, he said, and freed up his focus and his jump shot. Well, what if that baby had come a week later? Babies sometimes decide to do that. And I say all of this not to take away from the gamble Masai Ujiri made. I say it to note it was a much more giant gamble than he's even been given credit for. Nearly a year ago, Ujiri started placing a series of bets so mammoth they would make a bookie blush. And the fact that he didn't have that much control over how they'd turn out makes the fact that he did so even braver. How we got here to this matchup in these NBA finals, that was hardly a no-brainer. But it worked. And now the Raptors are the ones playing with house money. So would you place a bet on the Raptors, Richard? What would it take for you to say, okay, if that happens, they will win their first NBA championship?
If they make, you know, similar in-game adjustments like they did against Milwaukee, I think to beat Golden State with KD, without KD, to beat Golden State, you have to be able to make in-series adjustments at a high level. We got smoked game one and two, and then we made some serious adjustments, and our adjustments are what, you know, we kept changing it, and we kept adjusting till we figured out something that worked, and then we're like, okay, we just need to do it harder. If Toronto can do the exact same thing that they did against Milwaukee, get smoked in the first two games, we're just going to tweak things, and we're going to keep doing it harder, and we're going to keep doing it harder. If they do that, then I believe they have a chance.
I just think you have to keep the Warriors from dictating the pace of this game. I think you have to take the Warriors out of their rhythm, because they've gotten into an incredible way of playing the last few games here. And I don't want to say that's without Kevin Durant, but they have gone back to having to share the ball, having to involve everyone else, having to run that motion offense because they don't have Kevin Durant. But if you can take them out of the way that they like to play, out of that speed, out of that tempo, and slow them down and make this what Houston tried to do or what the Clippers tried to do, if you can disrupt what Golden State does offensively, then you've got a chance. And Toronto just did that to the Milwaukee Bucks.
Yeah, and look, I do think they've got to get on them early, and I mean early in the series. You have an opportunity here. You have two games at home. At least one is going to be without Kevin Durant.
Right.
Let's not kid ourselves. It sounds like both. They're talking about Kevin Durant might not even make the trip to Toronto. So
he's going on the trip.
He is going on the trip. Okay. Mm-hmm. He said, they said yesterday they weren't sure. Did they decide this morning?
They
fantastic.
Did this morning.
Ramona Shelburne, breaking news, as always. That's why she's an insider. Connected. He, I don't know if we're going to see him though in game two. You got to take advantage of it while you have it.
Oh, you have to because this team, you have home court advantage. That's one of the things that we have kind of glossed over. You have home court advantage against the Golden State Warriors. And that is something because Oracle is not a very fun place to play. It hasn't been. Like, look, they've had their ups and downs a little bit, but they're still at a record pace if you look at their last 5 or 6 years, how well they've played at home. So, you just have to take advantage of that. And role players, which are going to be the key, have to play well at home.